Yo, what's going on, guys? My name is Garu and welcome back to this new video. And in this video, I will be showcasing all the Fort Bay locations from Fort Bay number 1 to 100 in one single video. So if this video does help you out, please go ahead and drop a like on this video and share this video with your friends if they also need help with their Fort Bay challenges. And season 10 is coming up. So if you haven't subscribed yet, please go ahead and hit that big red button, which says subscribe, and turn on the notification bell, because with season 10 I will be going ahead and helping you guys out with all your season 10 challenges. And if you guys would love to support me, you guys can use my supporter creator code in the Fortnite item shop, which is gonna be real-garu. So thanks to each and everyone who is using it. And with that being said, let's get into all the Fort Bay locations from 1 to 100. So the first Fort Bay will be awarded for gaining 175k XP. The second Fort Bay is gonna be found at a location within loading screen number 6, which is going to be located in Neo Tilted at this exact place. This third Fort Bay is going to be accessible by using the Skull Trooper emoji at the westernmost point. So this one could be located at the back end of Snobby Shore, so go ahead and collect this one. The fourth Fort Bay is going to be accessible by skydiving through the rings above Loot Lake with the Plasma Trail Contrails equipped. So just go ahead and equip the Plasma Trail Contrails and go through these loops and collect the Fort Bay. The fifth Fort Bay is going to be accessible by using the Laid Back Shuffle emote inside a dance club. So just go ahead and use this emote and this Fort Bay is going to get unlocked. The sixth Fort Bay is going to be accessible with Yay emote at an ice cream shop. So this ice cream shop will be located next to the racetrack. So just go ahead and use the Yay emote and complete this challenge. Moving over to the Fort Bay number 7, which is going to be use cuddle up emoticon in a rocky umbrella. So just come over here and use the emoticon, which will be unlocked in your battle pass itself, and complete this challenge. Moving over to the next Fort Bay, which is going to be the Fort Bay number 8, found within Junk Junction. So this will be located inside the shed, so you guys can just glide down and collect this Fort Bay for yourself. Moving over to the next Fort Bay, which is going to be the Fort Bay number 9, awarded for completing 6 challenges from week 5. The Fort Bay number 10 is going to be awarded for gaining 60,000 XP. The Fort Bay number 11 has a location which could be found beneath a circling jungle parrot. Now the parrot keeps on, you know, circling at this exact jungle near Sunny Steps, so you guys can just look for the parrot, which will be hovering on top of it, and collect this Fort Bay for yourself. Moving over to the next Fort Bay, which is going to be the Fort Bay number 12, accessible by using the Nana Spray inside Molten Tunnel. Now this tunnel will be located next to the Tomato Temple, which has been taken out from the game, so you guys can just go underneath that tunnel and use the Nana Spray Paint and unlock this Fort Bay. Moving over to the next Fort Bay, which is going to be the Fort Bay number 13, which will be located at this exact place, which is going to be next to the dinosaurs at Paradise Palms in this shed. So just go ahead and destroy the shed and collect this Fort Bay for yourself. Moving over to the next Fort Bay, which is going to be Fort Bay number 14, found within an RV park, which will be located at the RV park, which will be next to the Mega Mall. So just drop near the green RV and collect this Fort Bay. Moving over to the next Fort Bay, which is going to be the Fort Bay number 15, awarded for completing 6 challenges from week 9. Fort Bay number 16 is going to say found in a desert house with too many chairs, which will be located at this exact place at the, you know, small town in Paradise Palm. So you guys can just go in and collect this Fort Bay for yourself. Moving over to the next Fort Bay, which is going to be the Fort Bay number 17, found inside a wooden fish building, which will be located at the hot springs, which will be located next to Lazy Lagoon. So you guys can just drop in over here, edit the structure, which is going to be at the tail, and get this Fort Bay for yourself. Moving over to the next Fort Bay, which is going to be found somewhere between Mega Mall and Dusty Divot, which is the Fort Bay number 18. So you guys can just drop at this exact small house, which is going to be next to the slipstream, and collect this Fort Bay for yourself. Moving over to the next Fort Bay, which is going to be the Fort Bay number 19. Accessible with the Vega outfit inside a spaceship building. So just go ahead and unlock the Vega outfit from your battle pass of season 9 itself and get this Fort Bay, which will be located right over here. Moving over to the next Fort Bay, which is going to be the Fort Bay number 20, found at the center of any of the first 3 storm circles. So depending on the game, if you guys get a circle, just keep on gliding up in the air and then just go at the center of the circle, and then there's going to be a Fort Bay which is going to look something like this. Go ahead and collect this and complete your challenge. Moving over to the next Fort Bay, which is going to be Fort Bay number 21, found inside a Metal Llama building, which will be next to Junk Junction itself. So you guys can just follow the gameplay which is going over here and get this Fort Bay for yourself just by, you know, gliding down over here. Moving over to the next Fort Bay, which is going to be Fort Bay number 22, accessible by using Rock Spray in Underpass, which will be located in Neo Tilted. So just go ahead and use the Rock Spray at this given location and collect this Fort Bay for yourself. Moving over to the next Fort Bay, which is going to be the Fort Bay number 23, found between an RV campsite, a gas station, and a monstrous footprint, which will be located at this exact place, which will be next to Loot Lake, so you guys can just glide down near this tree and collect this Fort Bite for yourself. Moving over to the next Fort Bite, which is gonna be the Fort Bite number 24 found within Fatal Field. So there's gonna be this house, which is gonna be next to the slipstream. So just go ahead and follow this gameplay, which is going on in the background. And as soon as you guys look to your left, there's gonna be a Fort Bite, which is gonna wait for you. So just go ahead and collect that. The next Fort Bite, which is gonna be the Fort Bite number 25, is gonna be awarded at Battle Pass tier 40. The next Fort Bite is gonna be Fort Bite number 26, accessible with the Bunker Jonesy outfit near a snowy bunker, which will be located at this exact place where I'm gliding down right now. There's gonna be, you know, this small island. But before you collect this Fort Bite, make sure that you guys have the Bunker Jonesy outfit unlocked before you glide down and collect this Fort Bite. Moving over to the Fort Bite number 27. Found somewhere within map location A4, which will be located right over here. And this Fort Bite is gonna spawn anywhere in the map location A4. So it will be located somewhere over here, as I'm showing you guys in this video. So just go ahead and collect this Fort Bite at the A4 part of the map. Moving over to the next Fort Bite, which is gonna be the Fort Bite number 28, accessible by solving the pattern match puzzle outside a junkyard desert. Now for this one, all you guys gotta do is solve the pattern match puzzle, which will be located at this exact place that I'm showing you guys right now. So go ahead and memorize that and hit those colors with your pickaxe. And once you actually follow that in a complete sequence, the Fort Bite is gonna get unlocked for you to collect and complete your challenge. Moving over to the next Fort Bite, which is gonna be the Fort Bite number 29, found underneath the tree in Crackshot's cabin. And this one will be located at this exact place where I'm showing you guys right now. It's actually gonna be a Christmas tree, and exactly next to that is gonna be the Fort Bite. So just go ahead and collect that one. Moving over to the next Fort Bite, which is gonna be the Fort Bite number 30, found somewhere within Hunt Hills and Pleasant Park. So if you guys have a look between Hunt Hills and Pleasant Park, there's actually gonna be a windmill, and exactly next to it there's gonna be a Fort Bite, which will be sitting exactly next to these trees. So just go ahead and collect this Fort Bite for yourself. Moving over to the next Fort Bite, which is gonna be the Fort Bite number 31, found at a Meteor Crater Overlook. Now this one could be found at Dusty Diners and the depot, which has been kind of broken. You guys can find this Fort Bite over there and just go ahead and collect that one and complete your challenge. Moving over to the next Fort Bite, which is gonna be Fort Bite number 32, accessible by wearing Keopet back bling. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is unlock the back bling on your battle pass and just go at this exact place where I'm showing you guys right now. And exactly next to Junk Junction, you guys can actually find the signpost. So just go over here and collect this Fort Bite for yourself. Now moving over to the next Fort Bite, which is going to be the Fort Bite number 33, found within Loading Screen 10. So this is going to be the exact place where you guys can find this Fort Bite for yourself. And moving over to the next Fort Bite, which is going to be the Fort Bite number 34, found between a fork and knife. This fork and knife will be located next to Fatal Field, so you guys can just drop down over here inside this place and get this Fort Bite for yourself. The Fort Bite number 35 is going to be awarded for gaining 2225k XP. The Fort Bite number 36 is going to be accessible by Sentinel on a frozen island, so this is going to be the exact place where you guys can go and complete your challenge by wearing the Sentinel outfit. So just make sure that you guys have that skin equipped when you're trying to complete this challenge. Moving over to the next Fort Bite, which is going to be the Fort Bite number 37, found inside a disaster bunker basement in Pleasant Park. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is drop down inside this house and go exactly at the bunker, which is gonna be straight down. And once you guys reach over there, there's gonna be a small little room, and just go over there and look to your left, and there's gonna be a Fort Bite which will be waiting for you. So just go ahead and collect this one. Moving over to the next Fort Bite, which is gonna be the Fort Bite number 38, which is gonna say accessible with the Vendetta outfit at the Northernmost Sky platform. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is unlock the tier 100 skin and go at this exact sky platform. And exactly as you break this thing open, there's gonna be a Fort Bite which is gonna wait for you. So just go ahead and collect that one. The next Fort Bite is gonna be the Fort Bite number 39, awarded for completing 6 challenges from week 2. Fort Bite number 40 is gonna be accessible with the Demi outfit on a sundial in the desert. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is equip the Demi outfit and go at this exact place, which is going to be the sundial, which is going to be next to the oasis and the truck stop sign. So just go over here and complete your challenge. Moving over to the next Fort Bite, which is going to be the Fort Bite number 41, accessible by using tomato head emoticon inside the Dura Burger restaurant. So just go ahead and equip the tomato head emoticon and use this emoticon in Neo Tilted inside the Dura Burger restaurant to complete this challenge. Moving over to the next Fort Bite, which is going to be the Fort Bite number 42, awarded for completing 6 challenges from week 3. Fort Bite number 43 is gonna say accessible by wearing the Nana cape back bling inside a banana stand. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is equip the Nana cape back bling and drop in at this exact place, which is gonna be Neo Tilted in front of the Peely's banana stand, and just go over there and you guys will find this 4th byte as shown in this video. Moving over to the next 4th byte, which is going to be the 4th byte number 44, awarded at Battle Pass Tier 20. 4th byte number 45 is going to say awarded for completing all Season 9 weekly challenges, which are like 70 challenges. The next 4th byte is going to be 4th byte number 46, awarded at Battle Pass Tier 100. Now coming into the location for the 4th byte number 47, is going to be found between a Reboot Van, Pirate Cam, and a crashed Battle Bus. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is pinpoint this place in the minimap, and then you guys can just come over here and collect this 4th byte. Moving over to the next 4th byte, which is gonna be the 4th byte number 48, accessible by using the Vox pickaxe to smash the gnome beside a mountaintop throne. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is equip the Vox pickaxe and smash the gnome, which will be located right over here. So as soon as you guys do that, the 4th byte is gonna get unlocked, and just go ahead and collect that one and complete your challenge. Moving over to the next 4th byte, which is going to be the 4th byte number 49, found in Shark's Ice Cave. So for this one, all you guys got to do is drop in at the Snow Biome, and if you guys follow the gameplay, this is going to be the Shark's Cave. So just go and get inside the shed and break this thing open, and in front of those teddy bears, there's going to be that 4th byte. Coming into the 4th byte number 50, accessible at nighttime inside Mountaintop Castle Ruins. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is make sure that your game is on nighttime. And when it's nighttime, you guys can go at this exact place on top of the Haunted Hills Castle and collect this 4th byte for yourself. We are halfway done with all the 4th bytes for Season 9. If this video is helping you out so far, please go ahead and drop a like on this video. Coming into the 4th byte number 51, which is gonna be accessible by using the Clock Strut to cross the road in front of Peely's Banana Stand. So just a few minutes ago, I showed you guys where the Peely's Banana Stand is in Neo Tilted. So just go over there and use the Clock Strut emote to unlock this 4th byte. So just go ahead and collect this one. The 4th byte number 52 is going to be accessible with Bot Spray inside a robot factory. I'm pretty sure you guys saw the Season 9 event, so all you guys got to do is go in at Pressure Plant and take a right turn. And exactly over there, there's gonna be this 4th byte. So just go ahead and use the bot spray. And as soon as you guys do that, the 4th byte is gonna get unlocked. Coming into the next 4th byte, which is gonna be the 4th byte number 53, accessible by helping to raise the disco ball at an abandoned mountaintop villain lair. So all you guys gotta do is go there with a friend and use some emotes at this dance floor. And as soon as the disco ball rises up, the 4th byte gets unlocked. So just go ahead and collect that one. Coming into the 4th byte number 54. Awarded for completing 6 challenges from week 4. 4th byte number 55 is going to be found within Haunted Hills. So for this one, all you guys got to do is drop in at this exact house where I'm dropping in right now and go inside this house to collect the 4th byte. Coming into the next 4th byte, which is going to be the 4th byte number 56. Awarded for completing 6 challenges from week 10. 4th byte number 57 is going to be awarded by finishing top 10 in squads, duos, or solos 25 times. Coming into the 4th byte number 58. Accessible by using the Sad Showman emote at the north end of Snobby Shore. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is drop in at the house, which is gonna be at the extreme right side, and use the emote. And as soon as you guys do that, the 4th byte gets unlocked. So just go ahead and collect that one. Coming into the 4th byte number 59, accessible with the dire emoji inside Pizza Pit restaurant. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is drop in at Mega Mall at this exact place and go behind the counter and use the emoticon, which is gonna be the dire emoticon. And this 4th byte gets unlocked, so go ahead and collect this one. 4th byte number 60 is going to be accessible with Sign Spinner emote in front of the Happy Oink restaurant. So for this one, all you guys got to do is use the emote at this exact place that I'm showing you guys right now. And as soon as you guys do that, the 4th byte gets unlocked, so go ahead and do that. Coming into the next 4th byte, 4th byte number 61, accessible by using the Sunbud spray on a frozen waterfall. So for this one, all you guys got to do is drop in at this exact place and next to the Viking ship, you guys can use the Sunbud spray and collect this 4th byte for yourself. Coming into the 4th byte, number 62, accessible with the Stratus outfit within an abandoned mansion. So just go ahead and equip the Stratus outfit, which could be unlocked in your battle pass, and drop in at the abandoned mansion and go ahead and collect this 4th byte. Coming into the 4th byte, number 63. Found between Fatal Fields and Lucky Landing. So there's actually gonna be this gas station. So exactly in that gas station, you guys can actually find the 4th byte. Number 63. Coming into the next 4th byte, which is going to be the 4th byte number 64, accessible by rocks on top of Stunt Mountain. The Stunt Mountain will be located next to the football field, so just go over there on top of the Stunt Mountain with the rocks outfit and collect this 4th byte for yourself. Coming into the next 4th byte, which is going to be the 4th byte number 65, found on a basement budget movie set. Now this one could be located in the houses which is gonna be next to Shifty Shafts. So just go inside the bigger house and go downstairs and collect this food bite for yourself. Coming into the next food bite, which is gonna be the food bite number 66, awarded by finishing top 10 in squads, duos, or solo 75 times. So just go ahead and play some games with your friends and complete this challenge. Coming into the fort by number 67, accessible by flying the Retaliator glider through the rings under the southernmost sky platform. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is unlock the Retaliator glider and follow this gameplay which is going over here and collect this fort bite for yourself. Coming into the next fort bite, which is gonna be the fort by number 68, found within a Snowy Town bookshop. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is drop in at the bookshop, which will be located at Happy Hamlet, at this exact place, and get this food bite for yourself. Coming into the next food bite, which is gonna be the food bite number 69, found inside a Stone Pig building, which will be located next to Lucky Landing. So just go ahead, edit the structure, and get this food bite for yourself. This is gonna be a giant stone pig, so finding this thing is gonna be really easy. Coming into the next food bite, which is gonna be the food bite number 70, accessible by skydiving through the rings above Lazy Lagoon with the Vibrant Contrails equipped. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is equip the Vibrant Contrails. So just go on top of the pirate ship and glide in through and complete your challenge. Moving over to the next fort bite, which is gonna be the fort bite number 71, awarded for completing 6 challenges from week 1. Fort bite number 72 is gonna be found within Salty Springs, which will be located inside the red car, which is kind of, you know, tumbled upon near the reboot van. So you guys can just go over there and collect this fort bite for yourself, which will be at the center of Salty Springs. Coming into the next fort bite, which is gonna be the fort bite number 73, awarded for completing 6 challenges from week 6. Fort bite number 74 is gonna be found in a filing cabinet inside an assassin's basement on the desert coast, which is gonna be the John Wick's house here inside the game. So just go ahead and break this thing open, and as soon as you guys do that, there's gonna be a food bite inside this thing. The next food bite is gonna be food bite number 75, found within an airport hangar. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is drop in Frosty Flights at the airport hangar, and exactly as you look to your right, there's gonna be a food bite. So just go ahead and collect this one and complete your challenge. The food bite number 76 is gonna be found behind a historical diorama, which will be located in Neo Tilted in the No Sweat Insurance building. So just walk in straight, look behind the volcano, and there's gonna be a food bite which will be waiting for you. So just go ahead and collect that one. The next food bite is gonna be the food bite number 77, found within a track side taco shop, which will be located next to the racetrack in Paradise Palms. So just go ahead and look over here, and you guys will find this food bite for yourself. Coming into the next food bite, which is gonna be the food bite number 78, found within a ranger tower overlooking a drained lake. Again, I'm pretty sure you guys saw the event which took place at Loot Lake. So all you guys gotta do is go at this ranger tower, which is located next to the fancy houses. So you guys can just go on top of this thing and collect this food bite for yourself. Coming into the next food bite, which is gonna be the food bite number 79, found within an arcade. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is drop in at Mega Mall, and there's gonna be this arcade. So just look behind the counter, and there's gonna be a food bite waiting for you. So just go ahead and collect that one. Coming into the next food bite, which is gonna be the food bite number 80, accessible by using the Bunker Basher pickaxe to smash the rock, which is gonna be at the volcano rim. So all you guys gotta do is use the pickaxe and smash the rock, and as soon as you guys do that, the food bite gets unlocked. So just go ahead and collect that one, which will be located at Pressure Plant itself. Coming into the next food bite, which is gonna be the food bite number 81, accessible in the daytime near the mountaintop cactus wedge. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is drop in at Paradise Palms on top of this exact hill, and make sure that the game is on daytime so that the food bite is actually unlocked when you guys are dropping over there, because if it's nighttime, this food bite is gonna be locked. Coming into the next food bite, which is gonna be the food bite number 82, accessible by solving the pressure plate puzzle northwest of the block. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is apply some pressure on these pressure plates, and as soon as you guys do that, the food bite actually gets unlocked. So you guys can actually go ahead and use hamster balls, or you guys can go ahead and use some quad crashes, or you guys can go there with your friends to help you collect this food bite. Coming into the food bite number 83, which could be found in a rock garden near the coast. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is drop in at this exact place, and there's gonna be these rock statues at the edge of the water. So just go next to them and collect this food bite for yourself. The next food bite is gonna be the food bite number 84, awarded at Battle Pass tier 60. The food bite number 85 is gonna be awarded for gaining 30,000 XP. The food bite number 86 is gonna be awarded for completing 6 challenges from week 8. The Ford by number 87 is going to be awarded by finishing top 10 in squads, duos, or solos 50 times. The Ford by number 88 is going to be found somewhere within map location J3. So for this one, all you guys got to do is drop at this exact place. I'm dropping in right now. And this Ford Bite will be located at this J3 part of the map. So just drop in over here and get this Ford Bite for yourself. The Ford Bite number 89 is going to be accessible by flying the Scarlet Strike Glider through the rings east of Snobby Shores. So for this one, all you guys got to do is equip the glider, which is going to be the Scarlet Strike Glider, and glide in through, and you guys will actually find this Ford Bite flying up in the air. So coming into the next Ford Bite, which is going to be the Ford Bite number 90, awarded by finishing top 10 in squads, duos, or solos 100 times. So again, play with your friends and you guys can complete this challenge. The next Ford Bite is going to be Ford Bite number 91, found at a location within loading screen number 4. So for this one, all you guys got to do is drop in at this exact place where I've dropped in right now and get this Ford Bite for yourselves. If you guys are having any problems, this is going to be the exact minimap location. So go ahead and collect this Ford Bite. Coming to the next Ford Bite, which is going to be the Ford Bite number 92, accessible by using Rock Love Spray near a lava fall. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is equip the spray and go next to pressure plant, and as soon as you guys use the spray paint, the Ford Bite gets unlocked. So just go ahead and collect this one. The Ford Bite number 93 is gonna be awarded for completing 6 challenges from week 7. The Ford Bite number 94 is gonna be accessible by using the Scarlet Side pickaxe to smash up blue canoe under a frozen lake. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is go at the frozen lake, which is gonna be next to Polar Peak itself. So just go ahead and smash the blue canoe and get this Ford Bite for yourself. Coming into the next Ford Bite, which is gonna be the Ford Bite number 95, found at a solar panel array in the jungle. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is drop in at this exact place where I'm dropping in right now, and you guys can actually see that there's gonna be this huge solar panel array. So exactly next to that, there's gonna be this Ford Bite. So just go ahead and collect this one. Coming into the next Ford Bite, which is going to be the Ford Bite number 96, awarded at Battle Pass Tier 80. The Ford Bite number 97 is going to be found at a location within loading screen number 8. So for this one, all you guys got to do is go at this exact place as shown in this video and just go over there, and you guys will actually find this Ford Bite at this exact place. So just go ahead and collect this one. Coming into the next Ford Bite, which is going to be the Ford Bite number 98, found within a Viking longhouse. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is drop in at the Viking village, and exactly as you go inside the longhouse, you guys will actually find this Ford Bite on your left. So just go ahead and collect this Ford Bite for yourself. Coming into the next Ford Bite, which is gonna be the Ford Bite number 99, awarded for gaining 125k XP. And last but not least, the Ford Bite number 100 for season 9 is gonna be found on the highest floor on the tallest building in Neo Tilted. So for this one, all you guys gotta do is drop at the highest floor building, which is going to be this one, and exactly on top of that, there's going to be this Ford Bite. So those were all the 100 Ford Bite locations in season 9. If this video helped you out, please go ahead and drop a like on this video and hit that subscribe button right now, because every time whenever there's going to be a new Fortnite challenge, I will be helping you guys out with them, and season 10 is coming up, so I will be helping you guys out with them every single day. And yeah, a really big thanks to Tomasha Bear for helping me out with this video. He also makes videos on Fortnite challenges, so you guys can click on the circle which is showing up on the screen right now to subscribe to him. So please go ahead and show him some love. And yeah, my name is Garu, and if you guys want to check out my other videos on Fortnite challenges, then go ahead and check out this video which is showing up on the screen right now. And I'm gonna catch y'all in the next video. So till then, goodbye and have a great day ahead.